of the world. Oh, squeeze it out, Tiny. Squeeze it out. Oh, he doesn't have to go. It's your friendly neighborhood Slip Gator here, hanging out today, doing stuff and things on the Ark Survival Evolved Pooping Evolved server. Hope you guys are having a good day. I'm having a great day. We're back, doing stuff and things. The day is starting off. It is a great day. A little bit of rain to wash away the night. And we're going to do some stuff and things. I'm really excited. I got a couple of cool things playing. We're going to play around some of our new dinos that we got yesterday. Episode 98 today. We're so close to season 200. I'm excited about it. It's coming up in a couple of days. So keep your eyes peeled. But yeah, thank you guys so much for coming to hang out with me today. I'm really excited to do some stuff and things. Make sure if you guys like this video, don't forget, smash the thumbs up button and show your support, peeps. If you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe. So yesterday we got the Dimorphodon army. Here it is. We got all of our guys here. Some of them leveled up. I went around today and leveled some of the guys up. We got some guys that are really, really low. So I'm not ready to take them out yet. Oh, we got another level right here. See, like 193 health. That's just like not even a mouse on a wheel, peeps. They ain't even going to go. Oh, what? Did you get a level 2? No. There we go. This guy got a level 2, 91. So we're trying to get everybody up to about 1,000 health. And then we're going to start pumping melee damage as well. Oh, give me that egg, yo. We also bred a Dimorphodon yesterday. And we got baby. Right down here, here's a little baby guy. Ended up taming, or whatever, growing up to be 111th level, or 110, and I just leveled it up. So some cool stuff going on over there. But you know, one of the dinos that we haven't really played around with a lot is Bloodwing. Remember, this is our old guy. We tamed this Dimorphodon, like, way back when the server first started. He's been around for a long, long time. And then, and check it out, peeps. Look at his stats. 3,000 health. Unbelievable! 1,000 melee damage, 117% movement speed, and we haven't really played around with him very much. So today we're going to take him out and do some stuff and things with him. But also, let me go ahead and pick you up, homie. But also, we bred that 110, with baby. But I was taking a look over here. We got Jessica right here is 119. I think she's ready to go again. Yeah, she can mate since yesterday, and Bloodwing. I feel like they need to make a baby. It's going to be an amazing new Dimorphodon baby. And then maybe as we can breed them more and more, like, we'll get some much, much higher level guys. So that'd be really cool. But today we got to start off with Super Monkey, who we haven't got a name for. Also, if you guys want to, please make sure that you can leave a comment or follow me on Twitter and go ahead and tweet me there. I need a name for baby and we need a name for Super Monkey. So yeah, so you can do it in the comment section of the down there. You can follow me on Twitter at SL1PG8R. There's links in the down there underneath, right here, down underneath you if you want to do that stuff. But we got to start off today. We got to paint our monkey. Oh, we got another level. Check out his stats right now. We got 1,000 HPs on him and have been pumping melee damage a little bit. Up to 500% melee damage. So let's go ahead and paint him, peeps. And we're back. This is the best I could do with the tools that I've been provided. Oh, your tail's all messed up. What? Why is the top of the tail? I think I got the top of the tail. I guess I didn't get the top of the tail. Let's go ahead and get the top of that tail. There's some stuff that, like, the dinos have gotten a little bit harder to paint since they added the fur. Like, sometimes you can see there's, like, little spots and stuff. It's kind of rough. And then on the face, I tried to get a blue face, but it, like, feathered out into the paint job there. So we did a pretty good job of it. We didn't do bad. It's not terrible. It's not the worst. But it's good. And it's a girl. Super Monkey is a lady. Is your chest not painted? No, it is. I think that's just shadow. So Super Monkey's a lady. So we had to paint her white. So that's why we got a white lady now. So now we got a Super Monkey. Yeah, look at that thing, man. She looks so cool. I love our Super Monkey now. Now we're not gonna play with the Super Monkey straight away because we wanna let her level up a little bit more. I love that how white she looks. She looks cool. I like that. All right, so what we're gonna do next to start off the day with is we're gonna go ahead and get Bloodwing. I don't want your poops, homie. Let's go ahead and bring him over here to where Soft Lady Whip is, and we'll stick him in here like a so. And then we're gonna get Jessica as well. Where are you, lady? Oh, she got a level. Hold on, let's get her leveled up real quick. 800. Oh, one more level. We're done on health on her. Sweet! All right, so go ahead and put her over here with Bloodwing. Like so, and then enable wandering. Enable wandering. Start mating, peeps! They're doing it! We're gonna make a baby! Another baby. We're gonna see what level we get over here. I'll bring you guys back when she squirts out an egg. And we're back! She squirted out a baby egg! Did we just pick it up? Oh, where the crap did it go? Get out of here. Give me your egg right now. All right, we got our baby egg. All right, sweet. Let's go ahead and get out of the way, man. Hold on. Disable wandering. Okay. Let's squirt you out over here. Wait. Oh, no, I punched it. Stupid wall. All right, let's go over here like so. Squirt her down. Stop moving. Disable wandering. All right, we'll have Bloodwing right over there. We got the baby right over here. He's doing his thing. We'll go ahead and drop this Dimorphodon egg out here. I actually left my air conditioning on all night. All right, we got enough stuff and things in there. It's no big whoop. So now we are going to sit and wait for this guy to hatch. 110 was this baby. Oh, we got another level on it. Sweet. Oh, man, this is way better. We can only do one of these a day, but we get such a higher level Dimorphodon out of it. So we're going to wait for this guy to go ahead and gestate and incubate, pardon me, and then we will be RBs when she hatches. Or he. And we're back at 117, baby. Oh, yeah, that's what's up. Imprint. Other baby. We need a name for this one, too, guys. And then disable wandering. Follow me, homie. Come on over here, little baby dude. Oh, wait, you want some food before you die? No, that's cool. It makes sense to me. All right, there you are. Come on out here. I want to see what color we got on this one, too. Oh, it's taking its first little baby steps into the world. And it is cold-blooded, so let's get it out into the sun so it can get some warmth, because that's what babies need. Babies need warmth and beef. All right. Let's get on top of here. Follow Brawler. Let's get down in. What color do we get? Oh, cool. It's like white with like a really neat red kind of background-ish stuff and things on it. And then what do we get on this guy? Oh, no. Only 294% melee damage. 500 health. 294% melee damage. I think that baby had more. Now, I moved these guys around a little bit because I needed a little bit more space in betwixt all of them so I could kind of like do stuff and things. And then I could better see like if they had leveled up and level them up a little bit better. So now, all right, where's baby? There it is. So this one had 308% melee damage to start with. And what was this one? 294? So a little bit lower, I think. Yeah, 294. So a little bit lower, but still better than like an 18 or something like that. So not bad at all. Our Dimorphodon army is growing. We're getting even bigger. So we got to basically spoon feed this bad boy until it gets to 6.7 weight. So right now it's just right there. It's doing its thing. So we don't really have to worry about it that much. But one of the other things that I wanted to show you guys is really cool. Someone from the Slipgator, my Patreon fan server. And that's for Minecraft, not for Ark. But one of the people that hangs out over there named Mel Bell sent me this really interesting, cool thing. So, you know, guys, I've been talking about trying to get into, like, doing the painting stuff where you can, like, get automated or, like, import paintings. I don't want to show you yet, but I haven't really figured it out. I played around with it a little bit, and I just haven't figured it out. I haven't taken the time, but she took the time and said this to me. Oh, my God, look at it. It's a Slipgator logo. So she sent me a Slipgator logo as a paint. It's so cool. And I got it into the right space, so it was pretty easy to do. But as far as doing the conversions, I haven't got there yet. But we'll get there eventually. We'll figure that out. But so cool, so unbelievably cool. I think it's really great, and I love it. It's so neat. We need to put more of them all in and about the area. We got Slipgatory stuff and things going on, so that's pretty cool. All right. So down in here, I'm gonna have to take some time, just wait out the feeding process, so that we can make sure that our little new baby, other baby, doesn't die here. But there was something else that I wanted to do. Put some more food on there. So there is something else that I wanted to do real quick. We've got all these Dimorphodons now, and we've got that Oviraptor. And the Oviraptor is basically, I mean, we have enough Pteranodon eggs. We don't need any more of these guys. So do we have any Pteranodon eggs hanging out? We got one right here. Oh, yeah, give it to me. So we don't really need any more Pteranodon eggs. So what I think we're going to do is go ahead and disable wandering. We are going to pull the stuff off. No, I said disable wandering. I'm not sure if you heard me. Are you following me now? All right, following Tiny. So let's go ahead and pump HPs, I guess, just so it doesn't die. All right, and let's bring it over to the Dimorphodons because we could use Dimorphodon eggs. I think we're doing good on Stego Kibble, and I think we're really fine on Pteranodon Kibble for now. I think we have like 40 or 45 eggs over there. So we're going to bring the Oviraptor over here to the Dimorphodons and promote the egg-laying behavior over in here. Huh? Come on, a little bit closer. A little bit closer. Okay, okay, okay. Oh, perfect. You nailed it. Ace to KB. Stop, buddy. You're so good. So we'll squirt this stuff back on like so, and then we will set it to wander again, and then we should get horny Dimorphodons. Come on, get horny, man. I want to see how horny you are and how horny all my guys are. Are you going to do it? You're wandering, yo. Are you going to update or is it going to take a minute? I'm interested to see if the Dimorphodons at the very edge here are going to get their horniness, hornyized by the egg bait. Why you know enable wandering? Why you know have thing? All right, let's check our guy really quickly. Just to make sure. It may just take a second for that to update. What do you got going on here, man? All right, get all your meats. There you go. All right, are you guys making horniness yet? Weird. Maybe I need to let it wander for a second and then lay it down? I'm confused. There, are you wandering? That is so weird. Some sort of a glitch. All right, I'm going to figure it out and let our other baby grow, and I'll be your bees, peeps. And we're back. I'm just out getting some meat, and I had Bloodwing on my shoulder. Look at that, man. Bloodwing is just like OP. So I had Bloodwing on my shoulder, and I have Bloodwing set for aggressive, and I think I need to tone it down. Look how he's so OP, man. That's crazy. Are you going to follow me, or what's your deal? Oh, now he's... Wait, what? Is he eating that while he's on follow? Or maybe there was a bug there, and I just didn't see it. All right, so we're just out here getting some meat. That's what we're trying to do. All right, Bloodwing, come here, buddy. Where are you, homie? Come over here, come over here, come over here. We gotta tone you down. You're too crazy. You're too crazy. I can't even get him. There we go. All right. All right. All right. Stop. 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 No. 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 I can't. How are you supposed to set him for like not being aggressive? Especially with all this is gonna be like a huge disaster, because he's gonna make that guy. He's gonna make this Dodick ball up, and then he's gonna just. Okay, okay. So he's going to make the Dodick ball up, and then he's just going to attack it forever. Come over here, man. All right, now land somewhere nicely so I can set you to not aggressive. We need you to be on attack my target. So aggression to neutral. All right, there we go. And then, oh wait, no. Passive. Let's do this. Attack my target. Aggression to aggressive. Oh yeah, there we go. All right, attack my target. There you go. All right, so he's on. So he's doing his stuff and things. But the other weird thing is that when he's on the back of the dino... Okay, that's weird. Last time, I had him on my shoulder, and he just started to attack stuff. And that might have been because he was on... Oh, there he goes. See? He just, like, dropped off on his own. That's so weird. Like, why is he falling off my shoulder? I'm not really exactly sure. So at the very least, let's go ahead and get you on follow, get you back on the shoulder. And this is really cool. I want to take him out and take a look at how amazingly powerful he is. Okay, when I hit X. So when I hit X on this guy in order to stop him from flying, he went ahead and... Oh, this is so weird. He went ahead and jumped off. So can I get you on my shoulder? Okay, we got him. So why would X even do that? It's supposed to be double E. Okay, so that's cool. I gotta just get some meat for my guys here real quick. But we're gonna take Bloodwing out next and see how OP he is. That's gonna be the next portion of the video. Oh, also, I figured out what was going on with Eggbait. He was set to follow, so that's why he wasn't doing his thing. And then I separated all the dinos out. So all the Jessicas are in front here, all the ladies. There's all the ladies, and then all the dudes are in the back there. We have more dudes than ladies for sure. So they haven't laid any eggs straight away, which is odd. I would assume that we would have gotten more. Oh, there's one. We got one. All right, sweet. We got an egg. Give it to me. These are hard to see, man. They are right up their butts. These eggs are right up their butts. So we have one Dimorphodon egg now. And then let's check here real quick. Other baby is doing good. All right, 11.6 weight, so it's eating off the trough now. And we just got to get a little bit more meat for it. So, all right, let's go out and get some meat, and then we'll BRBs. And we're back with Bloodwing about to take on a T-Rex. Come on, bite me. Get him, Bloodwing! Get him! Bloodwing's taking on a T-Rex right now. I can't even believe it. Are you going to do it, homie? I think it's a lower level Rex. Get in there, man! Give me the battle music so it sounds epic! Battle music fail. Boom, ba-doom, ba-doo-doo-doo. Did you see that bite? Oh, baby. It was only a level 12, but he's doing really good. I've been taking him around to do some stuff with things. He took his first T-Rex, man. I can't believe it. He's, like, really powerful. Now, I want to check real quick if I'm able to here. Are you gonna like, stop moving a little bit? Maybe we can... Nope. Where are you going, homie? I want to check his HPs, because he took on, like, two Raptors, a couple of Brontos, a bunch of stuff. So let's go ahead and just check real quick what he's looking like here. Oh, his health is down. His health is down quite a bit. And I turned off victim item collection as well, which helps him to not pick up Garbo items. Just, like, all sorts of stuff, which is weird, because he shouldn't even have this stuff in his inventory, because I cleared it out. But he definitely took some damage, either from the T-Rex or the Brontos or the... Or the Raptors. It was a big fight. There's a couple of big fights there. But he's definitely taking some damage here. And he hasn't leveled up that much either. So I was surprised. I was a little surprised. I thought maybe he would level up a little bit harder, a little bit faster. Let's go ahead and grab some more meat and stick it on him a little bit more. Stick it on him a little bit more on him. Like a so. And he's gotten a long way. He's got to get to 7,919 to get to next level. But that's not that bad. I mean, considering how many... Where are we at on Ultimate Destroyer? 47,000. So he's still got some leveling up to do. We might be able to get him up to like 190-ish. Pretty cool. He's doing pretty good. All right, let's go out and get some more battles going on here, peeps. And we're back. I got Bloodwing set for aggressive. Just going to see how he does here. I feel like maybe 1,000 melee damage isn't high enough. But I want to pump his speed really bad. Are you getting it, buddy? Are you getting it? Get him, man! All right, there's one. Let's see, two trikes? What do you got? You got these two trikes, homie? Oh, yeah, get him, man! He got one down, only a level 8. No big whoop. And he got the other one. He's going after the Parasaur. Oh, which is going to run. I'll help you out a little bit. He's going after the Packy. It's over in one bite. Annihilation of the Packy is a thing. Now, anything that runs is going to be rough because he's not really that fast. This is cool, man. I like doing this. I can't even imagine once we get the whole Dimorphodon army going, what it's going to be like. There's like three... There's so many things over there. I don't know if we should get into that fight. We're looking for maybe smaller prey. Let's head over here. Let's see what kind of trouble we can get into. Oh, man. It's Bloodwing versus a Compi army. Now, I don't think he can hit these guys at all. Look at them all, man. Peace out, Compis. Oh, level 100 Compi dead. All right. Where's he off to now? So it really stinks that they have like... The inability to attack stuff that's really close to the ground. He's going to go after these Parasaurs next. This is just craziness, man. Look at him go. Get him. Get him, Bloodwing. Oh, yeah, get him, man. He can't escape. Oh, two Stegos? Uh-oh. This could be a thing, depending on what level they are. Are you going to go after him? All right, here he goes. Yeah, the inability to attack certain stuff kind of nerfs them a bit. But anything big, they should be able to get. All right, he's got 136 down. Get him, man! Oh, he's running. No, no, no. All right. Let's whistle. Oh, no, no, no. He's going to get in another battle. What's he doing now? What are you doing now, man? Oh, he's got that turtle he's going after. He's got it down. All right, all right, all right, all right. Come here, man. All right, we got the passive whistle. Let's go ahead and bring him over here real quick. I just want to check his health again to see how everything's going. All right, land, homie. He does look like he's a little bit hurt. I need you to land, buddy. Oh, there's that Quetz. All right, I'll check him out in the BRBs one day. Three Varantos, a couple of Parasers, a whole batch of stuff and things. Release the hound. Take it to the limit, man. What are you going to do first? Oh, yeah, get him. Are you getting him? Let me help you out here since you're too slow. All right, I got him. Where'd he go next? Oh, he's going after the Brontos. I'm concerned about his HPs. Like, I wish there was a way to monitor what their health is. Like, you know what I mean? Like, from a distance, there's not really a way to do it, I don't think. I can't really see through here. There's just no way. It would be cool if there was, like, a way that we could see what his health is at. Is he even hitting them in there? Oh, 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 oh. Don't get the water. He's getting them. And we're back. I think we found the limits of what Bloodwing is capable of. Down to 500 HPs after fighting three Brontos and a Parasaur. He's powerful, but he's in no way like a super powerful, all-powerful type deal. Like, you know what I mean? Like, we got to be careful with him. He can't... He by himself is not a powerhouse. He needs, I think, the Dimorphodon army. Whoa, whoa, whoa. What do we got going on? Oh, I'm worried. I was worried he's going to get killed. All right, so one of those Brontos was kind of high level. The Parasaur, I don't know. So I would be scared if I was trying to take him up against like a T-Rex or something like that. Like, I don't think he's really there. Like, he's not that super powerful. If we got like a 120 Dimorphodon, and I think you'd want to level him up a little bit higher. I think melee damage, I think the movement speed. Oh, wait, this isn't me. That isn't him. That's Ultimate Destroyer. But I think the movement speed, once we get up to like 120, we might start pumping melee damage again on it. But still pretty cool. Still pretty cool information. What up? What's up, man? How's it going over there? And we're back. Come here, Oviraptor. Oh, crap, we missed it. Come here, little baby Oviraptor. Did I get it that time? What? Can you not pick up Oviraptor? What the crap is happening? Did I get you? Okay, we got it. I decided that, you know, I was thinking about, I talked about in the other episode that we're going to take some of the Pteranodons and we were going to put them in the tower because we don't really need them anymore because we have like 40 eggs. Now, I realized that this statement was very unslipgator of me. Like, who only wants 40 eggs? Like, that is not the right amount of eggs. Like, 40 eggs, we need like hundreds of eggs. So I decided that we would get another Oviraptor, one for the Dimorphodons, which only gives us basically Megaloceros. You want some of this? Hot action? Are you feeling squirrely? Are you feeling blocked in? Get knocked out, Oviraptor. So, oh, I didn't even think about the fact that we might not have the right eggs to feed this guy. Oh my gosh, I gotta check that out now. He's only level 16, so we don't really need to feed him anything good, but we do need to feed him eggs and some sort of large eggs. Let us take a look here. Kairuku, Pulmonoscorpius, Pteranodon, Stegos, Argies, Raptors, Trikes, Parasaur, Titan Boa, Turtle, Dimorphs, Carno, Anki, Sarko, Packy, Rex eggs. We'll just feed him the Rex eggs. We've got a few of them. So I think we need a couple of these guys around just to increase egg production. I want to continue to get the Pteranodon eggs going and still get Dimorphs too, even if there's Megaloceros. But I feel like we need to have like 100 of every type of egg. Like, why wouldn't you want to have 100 of every type of egg? So we'll put these on this guy. We can only put six on him because he's too so little. He's just a little 16. And we'll get him tamed up and we'll move him over in a viscerally type area direction. And we're back with our new guy, Eggbait. He's Eggbait as well. He only tamed out at level 23. It's no big whoop. We just got another Eggbait. We got another Pteranodon egg. We're going to continue to gather them up. Is there any Stego eggs over here for us, peeps? You know, we should probably move the Stego. There's two Stego eggs. They're inside. Hello, the Stego eggs. Oh, baby. That's what's up. So we got those two Stego eggs. We need more dinosaurs. My base is getting laggy, but we just need more dinosaurs. Wait, we're on top of you now. We can't get off. All right, let's land. Nailed today's stick. Can't be stopped. All right. And then over here. Oh, hello, my super monkey. Oh, he's so cool. He leveled up again. We got him at 1,000 HPs. I'm thinking we want him to be higher than that. I'm thinking 2,000 at least. I don't know. But over here, one of the things I'm kind of interested to... I was interested and am interested to find out is that these dimorphs, they do lay eggs, but not at, like, the dodo rates. And most of the smaller dinos seem to lay eggs... Oh, of course, now you're, like, disproving my theory. They seem to lay eggs a little bit faster, but these guys, those are the first two. I think I've only found four total since I brought the egg bait over here. So we are getting some eggs. It is a thing. We should probably move Hotspot and Bluetooth up a little bit so they get egg horny too. Are you egg horny now? Wait, are you? It's not. They're not. Huh. Like, do I have to move them like right over here? Does it take a second? You're still not egg horny. What's wrong with you? Maybe you need to get Bluetooth over here too so you guys can do stuff and things even though I think you're brother and sister or father and daughter or whatever. This is disgusting a little bit. All right, there we go. Their eggs are underneath. I got it. So, oh, you got to level up as well? Oh, hello. Oh, hello. Oh, my God. So we'll put them over here too, get some more Rex eggs going in the mix. But, yeah, I think that's going to be it for today, guys. I had a really good time hanging out, playing around with the Dimorphodons. We made a new baby. We got a new egg bait. It's been a good day, peeps, but that's going to be it. If you guys like this video, please don't forget to smash the like button and show your support.